I give a shot of the ceviche of Greenland fish. Look at this beautiful composition of Greenland fish ceviche. At least there's no whale blubber in it.
I said I was not going to video all the meals, but the presentation is so beautiful. It has a New Zealand combination of lamb and Greenland cod. Steve opted for the pastrami sandwich and tossed salad for lunch. And I'm going to check out the vegetable paella.
A fruit sauvignon. Let's see what the heck this one is. I completely forgot to video my pumpkin soup, but come on, you know what soup looks like. The entree that we chose tonight is a pork tenderloin in croute. I also ordered a leek quiche. By now, I'm sure you can anticipate that most of us are just eating out of boredom.
I'm hungry.
You're eating because you're hungry? No, that's impossible. If you had seen his breakfast plate. This is some sort of mushroom thingy. Let's see what we've got going in here.
Steve has the salad caprese, mozzarella, tomato. God, is it noisy in here tonight?
We both ordered duck.
Pork is not known for its outstanding food, which is no problem. And I'm just saying, that's it. I just decided that that's a stuffing, but the duck is very good tonight. It's one of the better entrees that we've ordered. I doubled up on the creme brulee, and they said key lime pie. The score tonight is creme brulee 10, key lime pie 3. I'm giving this profiterole that has shrimp and smoked salmon. Then I ordered the same thing Steve has over there, which is a Waldorf salad. And the entree today is, well, what they call surf and turf. But their surf and turf is shrimp and a steak.
Here is my surf and turf. Reminds me of tater tots. I used to serve them to my kids.
Steve just gave the thumbs up on the shrimp.
This gets not bad at all for me. I will say they do a wonderful job on their vegetables. They're all nice and crispy, not steamed out or anything like that. Recognize how difficult it is to serve meals for 113 passengers, 80 some crew. Not easy. My double desserts for the evening is a very orange passion fruit sorbet and a coconut cheesecake. I'm beginning to sound like a commercial for Ponant Cruises, the Laboreal ship that we run in Iceland, but I really miss the choice of the 10 or some desserts every single day. This is some sort of a brioche pudding, like a bread pudding. Those are plums or cranberries inside. I did not care for the main course choices tonight, so I'm having a cheese platter as my entree and a salad. Our waiter told the chef that this is my entree, and they gave me like a double, triple portion of everything. Now, if that isn't unusual, I don't know what is. A creamy mousse of sake wine served with wasabi meringue. I will give it a try with it. Tonight is the last dinner aboard the ship, and they pulled out all the stops. It's going to be a big chocolate buffet afterwards. Look how beautiful their chocolate buffet is. For people like Steve, who's a chocoholic, he's going to be in hot heaven. Ooh. Now that is gorgeous, the cream puffs. Look at that.
It's time for a little bit of my own recap. It's difficult for me to know exactly what to say about taking a cruise up to Greenland or the Canadian Arctic. I would have to say out of the 111 passengers still on board, because two got injured right in the beginning, at least 100 of the 111 have been to Antarctica and probably have already taken other Greenland cruises. Steve and I have done the cruise around Svalbard. We've done the cruise around Iceland, and now this one. The Iceland was not an adventurous tour. You visit very well-marked places that are fascinating, and I encourage you to do an Iceland cruise. That was really great because it was cultural, also different bird species, and I will never forget the little Arctic terns and my favorite puffins. Between Spitsbergen and this cruise, there was more of a variation around Svalbard. People on this cruise are here because they've never visited Greenland, and it's their opportunity to go into the high Arctic, which is what we did. The highlight of today so far was that big Arctic hare. It looked almost like a mini kangaroo with longer ears. A big bunny foo-foo. You have watched the video, so I encourage you to make up your own minds about whether or not it's worth the considerable cost to do something like this. And tomorrow we're in Resolute Bay and we fly on home.